All right, folks, as a year goes, or in this case, like a year and a half, isn't it? It's been a while. It's been longer than usual. This season of Game of Thrones has wrapped, so I'm going to talk about Game of Thrones season 7, mostly the finale, since the meat of the point of a season happens in the finale. I'm going to talk about a lot about the finale, some stuff that happened previous this season, what might be coming. And yeah, a lot happened in this season. Some things stuck out to me. Some things make me think about where we're going. I'm going to touch on those things, which is me saying I'm not going to touch on all things. So after this video, after you have that knee-jerk reaction to be like,
you didn't talk about how Sam, Tarly, and Jorah...
No, I didn't. Just be cool with it. And that is a spoiler warning. If you have not seen Game of Thrones season 7, don't watch this. Because if you're one of those people who are like, I don't watch Game of Thrones, it doesn't matter to me. Eventually, you're going to watch Game of Thrones. You're going to be like, I shouldn't have watched Jeremy's video. But all right, spoiler alerts out of the way. Let's talk about some Game of Thrones season 7. Which the first thing I'm going to touch on is, yes, there are less episodes this season. There will be less episodes next season. Next season is like, what, 6? That's crazy to me. But in doing that, they were like, we need to get people from point A to point B very quickly. 5 minutes of screen time, that totally works to get across the continent. Whereas before, previous seasons Game of Thrones, it would take someone a couple of episodes to go from point A to point B, because it's like 1,000 of our miles. So, okay, I accept that reasoning, and it actually kept this season at a very fast pace. Like, when they were all trapped north of the wall, and all the zombies were like, we can't walk on ice, because we'll slip, or maybe we'll drown, because we breathe. Because, well, they're idiots. They're zombies. They don't know that shit. They don't know that they will be able to walk on the floor of the lake, and then come up, and then be able to kill people. But they can recognize that when a rock slides across the ice, you can go ahead and walk across zombies. Then Daenerys got there in like 2 seconds. Everyone was like, that is how, But again, with the condensing of the episodes, it's something we've seen all season long, so at that point, I just accepted it. Bigger picture shit would be like, wouldn't she freeze to death? Those dragons fly, I assume, pretty high. With wind chill and it being north of the wall, she's not really bundled up. Imagine she'd die of wind chill in about 10 minutes. That's the bigger concern right there. Not the fact that she has Chief O'Brien just beaming her with the transporter, but I gotta wonder, why have fewer episodes in the last 2 seasons? To my understanding, Game of Thrones is crushing it. So in the last 2 seasons, when everything has to pay off for the fans, the logic is like, well, this show is just getting bigger, more people are just talking about it on social media, so let's just slice the last 2 seasons down. I feel like they're just saying no to money, no to views. Season 7 and season 8 collectively will be 13 episodes. Was that the number they just came up with? At the end of season 6, were they like, look guys, we have 13 episodes of attention span with us and the fans. After episode 13, it's going away, so take that number, divide it however you want, and that's what we're gonna do. It's just weird. Why not just make them 10 episodes each? I would watch it, but would just stop. We did get to see Daenerys use her dragons a couple times in this season. That was pretty sweet. It was just gratifying. You'd seen them burn a little piece of steak in season 2. You saw them burn a human being. You're like, yeah, but how destructive can they get? We've heard stories, then you saw. And yeah, at the end of that episode, I believe it's episode 4 of season 7, you're like, that's a problem for everybody. Everybody in Westeros who's going to go up against Daenerys and her dragons is like, you gotta think about that. Do you really want to go there? Do you really? Then the next time, after Daenerys flew north of the wall, did not freeze to death, that dude was like, all right, let's go ahead and javelin that fucker. I just nailed the dragon. I got that ruined for me on Twitter, because people on Twitter sometimes are dicks. It was one of the leaked episodes. Point is, now the bad guys have a dragon, which is funny, because A, that's a problem, because you can only kill the dead with fire or dragon glass. Yeah, you can only kill the fire-breathing dragon with fire. That's strange to me. When Gandalf on cocaine was riding the dragon burning the wall, it was blue flame. Just found it funny that a fire-breathing dragon can only be killed with fire. Or maybe because it is still a dragon, it is still impervious to fire. Yeah, good guys are gonna have a problem. The question I have is, are main characters going to die? Leading up to this season, we were all like, anyone can drop at any time. You could assess or assume that Tyrion wasn't going to bite it. I assumed that because he's George R.R. Martin's favorite character. However, we are past the George R.R. Martin pages now. They're making this shit up as they go along. So again, I ask, would they have the real balls to kill main characters? Granted, Peter Baelish died. We all knew he would, though. Everyone who died at the Frozen Lake scenario, we knew they were expendable. Peter Baelish completely expendable. For the last couple seasons, I've just been looking at the guy like, why are you still alive? Granted, I did like how he died. It was just like one of these things like, all right, he's gonna turn Sansa against Arya and Sansa's totally gonna bite the bait. Then when she called Arya in and Arya's like, do you really want to do this? I was like, oh shit, dude, it's gonna be, she's gonna say Peter Baelish. She said Lord Baelish. I was off by one word. Point is, it was a good scene. It was time for him to go. Then when they're bonding, Arya's like, you're the one who passed the sentence. I just killed him. I wanted Sansa or one of them to be like, yeah, but father always said the one who passed the sentence should be the one who swings the sword. And well, that's not how we did it. Granted, it was a knife. I still feel like that makes us dicks. But again, will main characters die? It's the last season next season, so I imagine yes. The last season, all bets are off, man. Anyone could die. And for a while, when Cersei was like, all right, we'll fight with you, I was really scared. Like, okay, she's gonna die up there in battle against a dead walker. Then Daenerys would be queen by default by TKO. That's not exciting, that's stupid. But then she went back on her word. Jaime Lannister straight up gave her some logic bombs. He's like, okay, if the walkers win, we die. If the ones we're betraying win, we die. die. This is a no-win scenario for us if you do this. But hey, she's a dick. What can you say? So in the fact that this was the season that really didn't kill a lot of people, it didn't really kill the ones that gut-wrenched you, I wonder if George R.R. Martin's beating his head against the wall like, no, this is not the way it happens. Or if he's like, yeah, bravo, guys, this is exactly how it goes down. I don't know. Gotta wonder, though, and you can tell they are in territory where they are writing it. Before, they were going off George R.R. Martin's works. Granted, there were deviations here and there. So I've heard. But in this one, they're like, Dragonfire, that's cool. And it is cool, but it's definitely, tonally speaking, different. It was never the battles that made Game of Thrones great. It wasn't even the anticipation of battle. It was at first, maybe. It's the scheming and the Game of Thrones. A lot less of that here. This is pretty straightforward. Everyone who was at that meeting in the season finale, it was like, you hate that person, you hate that person, okay. I know where everyone's coming from. And we got super confirmation of Jon Snow's lineage. That's right, last season we got confirmation of Jon Snow's lineage. And then this season, we find out that Rhaegar Targaryen had an annulment with his wife and he got with Lyanna Stark. By implication, he got with Lyanna Stark, and then the end of this season, it was confirmed. And this is all really important stuff. Rhaegar Targaryen was actually a cool dude. I mean, you see the guy in this short clip they have, you're like, yeah, I'd probably hang out with him. I'm sure he's literate. He doesn't speak with a hammer. She seems very infatuated with him. It's a tragic lover's tale. These two fell in love in a world where they weren't allowed to, so a lie and a war broke out. History is written by the victors, so it goes down in history. Rhaegar Targaryen kidnapped Lyanna Stark and raped her. And that is not at all what happened. Like, imagine a world where you find out Mario was actually an asshole who made up a story about Bowser. Bowser and Peach were in love, but Mario just saw what he wanted to see because Bowser has to be an asshole because he's a dragon. Pretty much what happened to these two. We even got Jon Snow's name, holy shit. He's not Jon Snow, he's Aegon Targaryen. Named after the one who flew in with his three dragons and ruled everything. Which I wonder if that's foreshadow. Is there going to be another Aegon Targaryen on the throne? Bran Stark said he is the rightful heir to the throne, which you can argue possession is 9/10. Although Jon Snow is the son of Rhaegar Targaryen and Lyanna Stark, he is still Jon Snow. He's not legally Aegon Targaryen. But I still think that's really cool. Because Bran will totally spill the beans. And if he doesn't, Sam Tarly will. So at that point, when Jon Snow knows, then Daenerys will probably know. And if she knows, is that gonna cause tension with the two of them? Is she gonna be like, no, I've worked for this shit all my life, motherfucker. Of the rulers, I would want Jon Snow on the throne. I want him on the throne because really, he's never wanted it. Same reason everyone made him king in the north. So now I gotta wonder, by the end, is Daenerys gonna die? That would kinda suck in my mind's eye, unless they pull it off brilliantly. You're building this girl up who was sold to a Dothraki, who became a Khaleesi, who became a leader, who's gonna become a queen. And in the end, I don't know, she might die and Jon Snow will just take the throne. Bran became boring though. I don't know if he became boring or broken or both. He touched the tree and then now he's like, I see everything, I see all. It's like, alright, are there any surprises now? I know your lineage, Jon Snow. Great, could you go ahead and fill me in on the fact that Cersei Lannister's gonna betray us? You should know that. Is anyone gonna be surprised that a bunch of walkers have gotten through the wall? They should know that. In fact, they should have known that it was going to happen. I mean, if he's all-knowing, all-wise, past, present, and future and shit, I'd be like, Bran, your job is to spy on Cersei from 1,100 miles away all the time. I mean, when you have someone that all-seeing, all-knowing, anything that surprises the characters in the show is now a loophole of some sort. Because they shouldn't have been surprised. Bran should have seen it. He should know it. Oh, wow, Jon Snow and Daenerys, oh, God. Yeah, they hooked up. He should be seeing that shit, too. And the reason I like that is that is a scenario that does play into the whole Targaryen thing. Plays into the Westeros thing. Westeros is not Earth. In a lot of scenarios, I always felt like Westeros and Game of Thrones, the show in general, was not locking itself to Western culture. It wasn't like, ooh, that's socially unacceptable for us, so we can't show it. Targaryens banged their bloodline, man. And although those two don't actually know it, it happened again. To show me that the writers are like, no, we still remember what the show is. So guys, in the end, I was completely entertained by the season of Game of Thrones. It does move at a faster pace for sure. I do miss a lot of the scheming and plotting that were in previous seasons. However, in terms of how condensed this season felt, it does worry me. At the end of next season, I don't want it to feel like the Hobbit Battle of Five Armies. That was the one where I was like, that was the battle. That's what it was. That was when I was like, this trilogy should not have been a trilogy. And I don't want to feel like that for next season. This is Game of fucking Thrones, man. I want it to pay off in big ways, but I don't want it to lose what it was. But those are my thoughts. All right, guys, so Game of Thrones season 7. Have you seen it? What did you think about it? What did you think of the finale? Whatever you thought, comment below. Let me know. All right, guys, I want to give not a plug, really. This isn't a plug. This isn't a sponsored thing. It's just me being a human being here. Unless you have totally shut the news off, and I understand if you have. You've probably heard about Hurricane Harvey and all the flooding that's happening in Houston right now. A lot of people are having a hard time. A lot of people are not as lucky as maybe some people watching this video. And it's kind of a shitty, powerless feeling to watch it happen. You're like, what can I do about it? I'll just tell you what I did. If you text Harvey to the number 90999, you'll donate $10 to Red Cross. You don't need to put your credit card in or anything like that. Just tax $10 onto your next phone bill. That's it. If an estimated 200,000 people people watch this video and do that. That's $2 million. That can help a lot of people down there. If you don't want to donate to Red Cross and do the Harvey to 9099, do what you can. Find an organization that can help and donate to that. I just see a lot of tweets out there, you know, when people are like, we should come together and help each other. Well, now here's the time. That's my, let's make mankind better. Let's help out, so I hope you do. And as always, if you like what you've seen here and you want to see more, click right here to see more.